It's Absolute Radio at Virgin Media's V Festival, and I'm delighted to welcome into our camper van. Are we half of the specials? Are you?
Can I ask you a question first?
Yes.
Your name's Jeff Lloyd, right?
Yes.
Are you in relation to Pink?
Pink
Floyd.
Yeah, no, Pink. Well, yeah.
Next question.
Are we half of the specials? Are you six
we're,
people
we're
these days?
We're half of the specials. The top half.
Right. Yeah.
Yeah, the intelligent. Oh no. Yeah.
What would they be saying if they could hear you now?
Yeah. Rhythm section, lead guitar.
Yes. And where is Terry?
He's not here.
No. Well, he's smaller than I remembered. If he was.
He is. Yeah.
It must be great being a special at the moment.
Yeah, it's been a roller coaster ride this year, but it's
a lot of fun.
Fantastic.
We've just done the Far East, Japan, Australia, New Zealand. That was great.
Yeah. I mean, I was looking a couple of months ago at some old clips of you. I don't know if it would have been on Whistle Test doing Rudy.
What sort of clips?
On the internet. Why are there dodgy clips of you circulating on the internet?
It wasn't me either.
And I was wondering, would. You know, as young men like that, did you still think you'd be doing it like 30 years later?
Yes. No way.
No?
not me. No, if somebody had said 30 years ago, you know, in 30 years' time, you'll still be, you know, doing all these tunes, I would have said, you know, get out of here.
Yeah.
Ridiculous. But it's remarkable.
Are you having a blast then?
Yes.
I thought I'd be dead.
Yeah. Well, look at you.
I thought you were. No,
you're
here. I call it second life. It's like sort of not like second wind, it's like second life. You know? I mean, I keep pinching myself to find out while I'm still here, you know.
And you're playing here at the V Festival today, and you're on the same bill as Lily Allen. And you were saying that Lily is somehow embroiled in the specials getting back together.
Has she been embroiled?
Terry and Linval played with her at Glastonbury 2007, I think. And that was one of the sort of the things where we realised that perhaps there was a future.
Yeah.
The reformation of the specials, because I mean Roddy and I are still living back in Coventry, you know, where not a great deal goes on, and, you know, and we sort of we've been kind of out of touch, if you like.
I heard you got a new roundabout in Coventry.
Yes, Coventry City roundabout.
Like there's plenty going on.
We love it.
It's another way to get round it without going there.
get mugged.
I think Coventry's sort of almost back on the map in a music sense. Mm. Anyway, we've got a really, really heavyweight fan base, and you know, it's. They've been waiting, a lot of them, for like, you know, 27 years to see us again. And these gigs have just been rocking, you know.
Come back,
I mean?
To change the world again.
Yeah. Again. Save the world again.
In all this time, were you aware that there was an appetite there for it? You know, were you aware that bands were coming along who were influenced by the specials?
We knew it would be popular, but I never thought that it would take off like it has.
Yeah.
I remember when we did Best of All, which was that, we did a 45-minute set there as a sort of like a warm-up to the whole thing, see if it would work.
Yeah.
And Iris said to me before we went on stage, said, I don't think we know how popular we are yet, you know what I mean? And then after that, we got
an idea. The music's more important than we are.
Yeah, absolutely.
And what was it like?
Both of us.
Absolutely.
What was it like being in a room again? Where was the room where you were all together again for the first time?
My place, wasn't it?
It was in London. Yeah.
We rehearsed in Horace's, Brad's basement.
Yeah. I'm Brad, the drummer.
Right.
And Horace, the
bass player.
Yeah. Now you've been reminded.
I mean, we hadn't all sort of like lost touch. We'd all sort of seen one another more or less, you know, at various points in the past sort of 30 years. But it was the first time when we'd all been there, you know, behind our instruments and playing the songs.
Mm.
And it was weird because we'd been playing for about sort of 20 minutes and, wow, it sounds just like the specials.
Yeah.
It was uncanny. Really was strange.
So at what stage in that time did it stop being a mess? Because it got ugly, I mean, as it always does over money for a while there. At what stage did that stop being a problem?
It wasn't.
What?
That was a long time ago.
Yeah.
You know, and
it wasn't money, by the way. It wasn't.
No, we
wasn't
were
money.
Very young. You know, we were worked very, very hard, and I don't think we were able to sort of to stop and take a breath and sort of catch up on ourselves and sort of decide what we were doing, because it was being orchestrated by the business, if you like. Would you agree with me there,
I'd
gentlemen?
Agree,
And so I think it kind of. We were too much too young. We you know, burnt ourselves out very quickly.
If we'd have got a break after we'd done America, for example, or what if before we went to America or something like that, then it probably would have been a lot different. It'd probably been some longevity in it, but you know, it just got too much. It really did. You bang on. Yeah.
And are you finding that you're popular now in places where you never really sold that many records in the first place?
Yeah, we've just, as Roddy said, we've just come back from Australia that we never played first time round.
Touched the whole world.
Lindvall said a funny thing on stage in Tokyo. We played the Summer Sonic Festival in Tokyo and Osaka. And the night in Tokyo, it was just full of kids, you know, average age about 17, 18 or something like that. Lindvall goes, where's your parents? You know. Yeah. I mean, I thought it was hilarious.
Do I know your mum?
And what's next then? I mean, are you going back in the studio? What's the plan? Is there a plan, or are you just taking it as it comes?
We've got some more shows in England in November, and we intend to have a look at Europe next year.
Yeah,
and that's about it, really. You know, we'll just take it as it goes.
Yeah. Well, best of luck with it.
Thank you very much.
An absolute delight chatting to you. I'm really looking forward to the set later.
Thanks.